the military camped in Chamuka zone in Kamocha, a Kampala suburb, where a huge fire broke out last evening, killing at least two people. The police yesterday confirmed the two deaths and the loss of millions worth of property in the fire that began at around 7 p.m. Last evening, the Assistant Superintendent of Police and Deputy PRO for Kampala Metropolitan Police, Luke Owesigiri, spoke of a clash of electricity wires as having caused the accident. But by this time, another statement says the real cause of the fire is still unknown.
Several residents in Kamocha counting losses after fire gutted several makeshift houses last evening, destroying property worth millions of shillings. The fire reportedly started at about 7 p.m. when the majority of the occupants were still vending along Northern Bypass. Attempts to save household items were unsuccessful as the blazing flames sent neighbors running for their dear lives. The fire brigade trucks arrived moments later but could not gain access to the blazing structures as the place is congested with so many buildings and a swamp. Residents stood helplessly as fire consumed their property, with others wailing for the lost property.
This is not the first incident. We had another incident before. There was a fire gutted an electric pole. When I called them, they responded very fast. This time also they responded very fast.
The over the force of the electricity made her fall. Now in the how they go straight one straight one. I don't know English. I'm not very well educated.
Jimmy Mabirizi, the vice chairman of the area, says they are still uncertain of the cause of the inferno that destroyed property worth millions of shillings.
It's very unfortunate that we have lost people, very unfortunate that we have lost property. It's very unfortunate that the city has had to face this. Now we're having some challenges, and these are inherited challenges that the authority inherited at its inception, which is illegal structures and physical planning in this house. But going forward, KCCA has put in place the building committee, which is in line with the Building Control Act, to ensure that all property, all developments that are made within the city follow both the Physical Planning Act and the Building Control Act.
Some of the residents were overwhelmed by the loss and started crying. Many did not rescue a single thing from their houses, and up to now, do not know how they will survive.
Come on,
some have resorted to removing scrap, hoping to sell and get what to eat. Kampala Central Mayor Salim Uhuru and KCCA spokesperson Frank Nwabwine also visited the scene.
Well, I want to take this opportunity to send my condolence message to the aggrieved family. It's very unfortunate. We have lost so far two, and many are in hospital. I want to thank the police. It has done a fantastic job. It came in time.
Police and the army are still camped at the scene as investigations into the cause of the fire continue. Technicians from Umeme are also doing their best. Kampala Metropolitan Deputy Spokesperson Luke Owesigiri last night said two deaths of male and female adults had been confirmed and several injuries recorded. The deceased were identified as Okware Stephen, 29 years, and Amia Caroline, 18, all residents of Kamocha. Owesigiri said the fire is suspected to have started after sparks from nearby electricity lines. Story by Ronald Kasasa for the news in Kamocha.